It has been around 20 million years since the end of the mid-Cretaceous. The Earth has experienced great change in both the shape of the world and its inhabitants. Gondwana has since broken up, and the continents are slowly moving into the positions we know them today. The climate has become warmer, and within the forests and plains of the Cretaceous, flowers and broad-leaved trees make up the bulk of the local flora. Among the dinosaurs, much has occurred in the past 20 million years. Gone are most of the giant sauropods and great carcharodontosaurs of the south. Gone are the mighty spinosaurs that once dominated the wetlands of Gondwana. And gone are the massive species of dromaeosaurs and iguanodonts that once flourished in the northern continents. As of now, global sea levels have risen immensely, with an inland sea splitting North America into two land masses. Here, a brand new cast of dinosaurs has evolved to populate the land, some of which are truly terrifying. For dinosaurs, life in the Cretaceous can be brutal and violent. But for a little hadrosaur named Scarlet, there's more to life than just dodging predators and keeping up with the herd. When she grows up, she'll have to support a family of her own. And here, danger lurks behind every corner. Growing up alongside her is Modok, a tyrannosaur destined to rule over this world. But the road to the top will not be easy, nor painless. These are the stories of the savage, untamed, and incredible founders of the American generation here on Dinosaurs Unleashed. It has been around 150 million years since the first dinosaur set foot on this earth. From that first creature has come an astounding variety of these mighty beasts, and now they are more advanced than ever before. This is a pair of young Prosaurolophus, each at around 5 years old. We will know the left one as Scarlet, and the one on the right as Violet. Under the protection of their devoted mother, Scarlet and Violet feed and play in this new world, completely oblivious to their family's importance in the story of the dinosaurs. Scarlet's world is one dominated by perhaps the greatest diversity of dinosaurs to ever exist, greater even than in the late Jurassic. It's a true American Serengeti. Among the new lords of the land are the ceratopsians. Once the hornless, bipedal creatures of the past, they are now large, powerful, and armed. Ankylosaurus, a 6-meter-long animal with a large nasal boss. Styracosaurus, another 6-meter-long ceratopsian, but with a long, sharp horn for defense. Armored dinosaurs also live here, like the 6.6-meter-long Edmontonia, with its lethal spines. But the most common herbivores of these plains are the hadrosaurs, like Prosaurolophus and Grippasaurus. Hadrosaurs, or more commonly known as duck-billed dinosaurs, are in fact descended from the iguanodonts of the early Cretaceous, and have since improved upon their ancestors' successful traits. For their time, iguanodonts like Iguanodon and Iguanocolossus were successful enough because of their jaws. But as time grew on, the plants they fed upon became tougher, and so required some adjustments to their original design. The hadrosaurs were the answer to those problems. Their jaws were much longer than those of iguanodonts, with beaks better designed to bite off tougher plant material. And their cheek muscles became larger to speed up chewing and hold more teeth. In Edmontosaurus, a later relative, there were as many as 100 teeth inside its mouth, all designed to grind food to a pulp. With so many herbivores in this area, you might think there is severe competition for food. But that isn't the case here. Edmontonia feeds on low-growing plants. The ceratopsians concentrate on the more succulent foliage above that, and the hadrosaurs, rising up on their hind legs, can get to food most other dinosaurs can't reach. And with so many herbivores around, predators can have difficulty hiding from watchful eyes. But the theropods, too, have evolved to better hunt these new herbivores. Dromaeosaurs, like this Sauropsis, lurk in the shadows. But they aren't the giants of the early Cretaceous, and so don't often hunt the big herbivores. With the extinction of the great Carnosaurs, a very different group of theropods have seized control over the niche of apex predator. We'll be right back. the course of the Cretaceous, the Tyrannosaurs have diversified into a myriad of species, each with different ways of killing prey, all equally formidable hunters. And 75 million years ago, the biggest and baddest of them all was Dasplitosaurus, a 9-meter-long killer with a truly lethal edge over his competition, a bone-crushing jaw filled with teeth shaped like railroad spikes. Unlike the thin blade-like teeth of the Carnosaurs, used to slice and tear flesh from prey, Dasplitosaurus' teeth are designed for maximum crushing power, able to pulverize bone in one single bite. When it comes to male Dasplitosaurus, this one is the biggest in this area. But when it comes to gender, he is not the superior sex. She is. To ensure that he's not a rogue, he must be checked. Fail this, and he'll become dinner for her. He's clear. She has good reason to be wary. Two females and a male, the hopeful future of these powerful predators. At 10 years old, these chicks are almost old enough to hunt with their parents. Already, they show a great enthusiasm for hunting. This is the eldest of the three, Modoc. He's bold and adventurous. The ceratopsian is simply too much for him, for now at least. Back at the herd, calm has been restored. From the moment they are born, baby Prosaurolophus cling to their mothers for support and protection. It's a bond that leaves a lasting impact on them for the rest of their lives, and this behavior is passed down from generation to generation. But life, as it happens, is unpredictable in its course. A few weeks pass. Scarlet and Violet remain the playful siblings that they always have been, going further away from their herd. But today, their lives are about to change forever. Watching from afar is Modoc and his parents. In the weeks since we last saw him, his siblings have perished, leaving him the sole surviving chick of his clutch. Today, MODOK is on his first hunt with his parents. Working together as a family, they can all reap the rewards of a successful hunt. But this success hinges on the shoulders of MODOK.
Thank you.
1 month later, and as the dry season begins, the Prosaurolophus herd forages for whatever fresh plant material remains to be eaten. For Scarlet and Violet, life has been tough without their mother. Female Prosaurolophus retain strong bonds with offspring, but they will not simply adopt orphans. Without the support of another adult, the sisters will be forced to fend for themselves while keeping up with the herd. Their situation isn't helped by the arrival of another Prosaurolophus, who is joined by her own baby. Having become lost from their own herd, the duo seems welcomed by this one. The baby is curious of the sisters, but Scarlet isn't willing to share. Had their mother been here, she'd protect them from the newcomer, but now they must accept a newfound place in the herd. Life isn't much better for the Dasplutosaurus family. The female has grown tired of her mate. The male leaves without much resistance. He knew this day would come. The mother seems unnaturally aggressive, but instinct now tells her that MODOK is old enough to fend for himself. To her, he is nothing more than a threat. Now, MODOK must face his greatest challenge yet, living on his own. It is the hardest lesson of all, and for Scarlet, Violet, and MODOK, the future is clouded in uncertainty. But for any animal, it is the greatest lesson to master, for it is the one that will define their destinies and those of their children. The stage is set, and now the American generation must face their ultimate test, paving the way to continue their line.